change your position. If you just wait for the force fields to melt, then you could be in big trouble, and it could be problematic for your army. Now, with the Thermal Lance upgrade, Colossus is going to be able to take out a fair amount of these Zealots with the splash damage, but so many Stalkers right here. Zealots tanking some damage. They were able to take out that Colossus. More Zealots warping in for Nizlof, going to be able to take down these Stalkers, and it looks like Nizlof is going to clean this up with a fair amount of ease, having several gates to warp in units. Looking at six gates here. Both players have six gates. Nizlof with the double barrel Robo, and now a Stargate as well. And a fair force over here that he can take and move out if he would so choose. More Stalkers warping in for Shamosh, and that was a very nice exchange for these two guys. So a little bit of a wait early on for the battle. I know I tell you guys when you are submitting replays, I'm sorry, to, you know, we want to see at least some action in the first 10 minutes. And this, we didn't see that in this case, but I think we are going to see some good back and forth now that both armies are established. And but I think what we're seeing here is just the macro of Shamosh is winning out over the tech of Nizlof. He just straight up has more guys. I think we saw that again, even though Nizlof has more food than has higher food, Shamosh is just getting more stuff. And you hear Day 9 talk about this all the time. If you can have more stuff than your opponent, a lot of times you can beat higher tech units. Looks like he's got Blink finished. How are we doing on upgrades here? Level 1 upgrades done for Nizlof. Have we done any for Shamosh? Not even one. I'm ashamed of you. But now you've got some Immortals in the mix. Going to be very good against these Stalkers and these Colossus if they can get within range. I like the idea of bringing in some Void Rays into the army mix. I don't know how good it's going to play because of the number of gateways that Shamosh has and is able to warp in units. Got to keep those Colossus in the back. Many an army has been laid waste because they don't keep their Colossus out of harm's way, and right now they're in the first 3-4 units to come in, and again using force fields to cut off the army, but Blink basically nullifying those force fields for the most part. But Nizlof coming in, going to be able to take out this Nexus before this army is able to come back. But now all kinds of Zealots, Immortals in the back, Stalkers in the back of them, but Colossus just able to rain fire down on these level 1 units with no upgrades. But as I said before, just Shamosh had too many units for Nizlof to deal with, and now he's going to quickly pop that Void Ray, and that is a win for Shamosh. Again, just outnumbering. And if Nizlof wants to do something about that warp in, he's going to have to bring a probe out to help and warp in a pylon over here somewhere so he can reinforce his army faster. I like this placement of the cannons. You want to guard your base, block that off, especially when you know you're not going to be able to get to that area to defend in any kind of fast manner. Number of cannons, you see the pros do that. I see particularly Huck. I was very surprised the first time I saw Huck. I think it was again in a game against NST, where he just made a ton of cannons in the bases where he couldn't be. But here we have a two-prong attack coming in. Zealots and Stalkers from one side, Stalkers from the other side. Going to do all kinds of damage, but these Colossus are going to make quick work of that army. But already we have more working in down here. again, we'd like to see a probe come down. We do have that pylon right there, but it'd be great to have one up here on the high ground over here. Get that. You're just about at enough money to expand. You're going to need that money, Nislop. You're about to mind out over here, and you're getting low at your expansion. Shamosh also in the same, completely mined out in his main. And finally got the third back up here in the middle. And here comes Nislop for yet another push. The cannons, looks like they're going to help this time. Lots of Colossus, however. And lots of sentries, but not using them for force field. Well, I guess at this point, if anything, you got to use them for guardian shield because that +2 armor against range is very helpful, and it's all you can really do against Colossus as they walk through those force fields. Looks like things are going to be starting to wind down here. Nislop looks like he's taking a fair advantage. Yeah, way! Holy crap. Look at that food advantage. Where are you getting all these monies? That's a good question, since Shamosh has the most bases. Or did, anyway. But now Nislop, I wonder if he's... Well, I should be able to see. I'm deserving, so I guess he hasn't really used Hallucinate. Hallucination. Or we would have been able to tell as observers. And now Nislop is expanding. Man, that was pretty rough because we saw all that macro. I think what happened was I was talking about how macro was beating up on the tech army of Nislop. However, Shamosh was needed to spend because the army kept getting wiped out and needing to be replenished. Even though it's cheap and fast and can often overcome a tech army like that, it does have to be replenished much more, particularly at a moment like this. And so Shamosh is going through his minerals at a faster rate than Nislop. So now that he's down that base, he is in deep, deep trouble. Not going to be able to hang in there at all. Although he's already added 30 food since we last looked. But Nislop's force is over the top at this point. I don't know what Shamosh is going to do with all of those sentries unless he's going to hallucinate a bunch of immortals, but he does not have hallucination, so he's not going to be able to tank that damage. And this is just going to be a raffle stop right here, and it's going to have to end the game. There's got to be a GG in here somewhere. Come on. This game is over. At least half of those have to be hallucinations. Actually, they're not. Nope. No hallucinations. Nislop taking his time. Good game, then. Shamosh gives it up, and there is the win. So, thanks very much for hanging out, chilling out. Now he's calling the hacker. Alright, anyway. Thanks for hanging out, thanks for watching. If I can remember what the scenario was in this game, I'll put it in a little annotation at the beginning of the video. But thanks for hanging out, guys. Keep climbing that ladder. Don't forget, we are now on Facebook and on Twitter. Just search for Noobcast, N-U-U-B-C-A-S-D, and you shall find us. Holla back.